Snestruck.
I just finished doing that Super Star Wars video, and man, those games take a lot out of you, so I'm gonna take it easy for a bit with a simple single-screen puzzle game called Bust a Move. Many of you might know this one better by its Japanese title, Puzzle Bobble. It stars the two little characters from Bubble Bobble and features a lot of the same themes and art design from those games. Bust a Move is one of those games that's gotten a gazillion ports and sequels, sprawling all over the place from 3DO, Sega Game Gear, WonderSwan, Neo Geo, Neo Geo CD, on and on. Maybe the most famous of these games are the arcade sequels. They are crazy as hell, and if you like puzzle games, I recommend busting out the MAME emulator and playing through a couple of those. But for this video, I'm sticking with the Super Nintendo cartridge, which is pretty scaled back and simple, but not in a bad way. This is still a perfectly okay port. The way the gameplay works is your character shoots colored bubbles from the bottom of the screen to the top, matching a group of at least two of the same color to eliminate them, the goal being to get rid of all the bubbles before they accumulate past the end line at the bottom. The catch is, there's a time limit, both to fire off your bubble and to finish the stage, since the ceiling is always moving downward. The controls are very simple. Press B to shoot and aim with the D-pad with that helpful arrow there, but it can be really tough to shoot into tight corners like this. What helps though is that you can use the L and R buttons to move the arrow pixel by pixel if you need to. The further you progress through the game's 100 rounds, the more colors you have to deal with, the shorter the time limit, and the trickier it is to make certain shots. You can use the walls to bounce the bubble off and reach spots you couldn't otherwise, and there's also special bubbles that create certain effects when you reach them, like the flame bubble. Shoot a bubble at it and it'll wipe out every other bubble of the same color in the general area. You get 7 continues here, and there is a password system, so you can skip to a certain level if you'd like. There's also a versus mode here, not only against a second player, but against the computer. There's a total of 10 different computer opponents you have to beat in a series of 3 games each. And man, let me tell you, you may not believe it, but that computer fellow is actually pretty dang good. Yeah, these levels get absurdly difficult after a certain point. The key component to getting ahead of your opponent in versus mode is creating dropped bubbles, meaning you pop a group of bubbles that are placed further up the screen, which results in a few other bubbles falling. This fills a gauge on your opponent's side that sends up even more bubbles, making things much more difficult for them. This aspect is what puts the game over the top as a really good two-player game, and it makes life hell for your opponent, and conversely it's frustrating as hell to deal with. Or maybe you'd rather approach Bust a Move as a classic single-player arcade game where you just want the highest possible score, and this game can accommodate that as well. The dropped bubble mechanic is just as important there too, since each dropped bubble starts at 20 points and doubles for each subsequent bubble. My only real problem with the Bust a Move SNES port is you're stuck with the same music looping again and again and again. At least the versus mode has different music to get sick of, but I mean, they couldn't have put at least one other song on here? Jeez. So yeah, Bust a Move, or Puzzle Bobble, is a perfectly good single-player or two-player competitive puzzle game. It's not as crazy or insane as the other more advanced ports, or the arcade sequels, which are incredibly addictive, or the more recent 3DS game, Bust a Move Universe, which offers a ton of different game modes. No, the SNES port is very humble. It's simple by design, and that's totally fine. It's a good game for what it is.